I thought it would be a good idea to do a track-by-track description of the forthcoming album, Chasing Daylight. But instead, I think what I'll do is just introduce the musicians that have contributed to the making of this album. I've had the great honor and privilege in working with some incredible talent, in which I'll describe in detail person by person as we go. I wanted to leave the interpretation of the songs to each and every one of the listeners that will listen to this album themselves and draw their own conclusions. For me, music is very cathartic. I really enjoy the process of making an album, much more so than listening to the end result. I don't often go back and listen to an album once it's done and finished for various reasons. One, I've listened to it about 100,000 times and it's kind of like, well, okay. But two reasons that I make music is, one, to have a certain musical snapshot of what it was like for me during that time, what I was going through emotionally, and the other reason is to have a snapshot of what was I capable of musically during that time. And so I would like to introduce to you all the wonderful and talented musicians that have contributed to this project. I worked with Cory for the first time back in 2015 when I was recording The Primitive Mountain. And since then, he contributed a lead to the album Endure the Fire, and also another lead to the last album, Sophia. And I think it's very safe for me to say that I believe that Cory is an absolute musical genius. The way that he thinks about music, his approach, and also his execution is absolutely staggering. Cory contributed a lot of guitar arrangement ideas, obviously a lot of harmonies that he introduced to the album itself, really thickened and broadened the sound itself, and it's always a pleasure to work with Cory and to see what he does. I think there were only maybe one or two spots that I kind of didn't really agree with. Otherwise, every idea that Cory brought in, I just said yes, 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 and yes. And so his ideas and musical vision, despite the fact that the guitars were already written to that by me, his ideas, his contribution, his arrangement, and his harmonies that he brought in really broadened and opened up the sound of the album and gave it a whole other spectrum. And it's always a treat to work with somebody like Cory that has such high musical caliber, and I'm able to learn and kind of peer into his world of music and see how he would approach something that I would never have thought of. So it's, again, always a treat to work with somebody like him that has such great musical vision. I haven't actually met Steven personally. Steven lives in Flagstaff, Arizona, and I live on Vancouver Island. I saw Steven's cover on YouTube of a song that he did. I think it was an Animals as Leaders song. I can't really remember. But I was really impressed by the performance, and kind of digging deeper into who he was, I noticed that he was actually a student of Ryan Van Porteren, who played on the album The Primitive Mountain as well. And so I remember texting Ryan. I said, hey, I'm thinking about this guy, what do you think? And he actually gave Steven both thumbs up, and he said, yeah, he's a great drummer. I think he would work really well for what it is that you're looking for. And so I contacted Steven. Steven said, well, send me the demos. Let me see what I think. And so I sent him the demos, and he liked it. And he started tracking the album slowly. During the time that I was sending him the demos, I was still in writing process. So we were kind of hashing things out and sending it to him, and then I had to retract and being like, well, I'd made a change here, can you do that? So it probably drove him a little bit crazy, but overall, Steven did a fantastic performance. Despite our distance and the inability for me to be there when he's tracking to produce him, I think he did very well. He followed my vision in a good way, and I think he did a phenomenal job. And you know, I think one of my favorite parts of his is in the last instrumental part on Vacuous. I really tried to push him to be like, Steven, do more. This is the part for you to build it up and shine. So there are a couple of parts there that he did that I was really, really impressed. And I think his performance on that track, I think, is the best. You can tell that he was really into it, and it was really cool. The performance was great. And again, another musician that is a great contribution to this album and gave it a good vision of what he wanted to do as far as his performance, mixed and matched to some degree with what I had initially in mind for this. So it's great to have had Steven do his tracks on the album. It was actually Cory who brought in Oswin for this project. I didn't really know of Oswin until Cory mentioned him. I know now that he's the lead guitarist in the band Threat Signal, and now I'm Monolith as well. And Cory brought him in because he thought he would really fit that lead guitar in Vacuous. Oswin is an incredibly talented guitar player. He's incredibly educated as well. He knows his stuff inside out. And the lead on Vacuous that he did was really challenging because there wasn't any room for there to be a lead to begin with. It's sort of kind of like a very chaotic part. And I had a vision of a very chaotic yet organized solo to add to that part. And I think Oswin did a phenomenal job in interpreting that. He did a few takes with Cory, and it was Cory who was actually producing that solo when he was doing the takes, and I think he captured it really beautifully. Also, he ended up doing the lead guitar for Chasing Daylight, which was originally intended for Devin Townsend to do, but considering Dev was super busy with recording an album and moving and all that stuff, that unfortunately couldn't happen. But Oswin stepped in as well and did the lead for that, and it's great to have him on the album for sure. Toño and I worked together back in 2015 in a project called 30 Dirty Thoughts. It's kind of a fun project that I actually played drums on. Since then, Toño has moved back to his hometown of Mexico City, and he's involved in many projects, mostly now with his band Archetype, but he also does session work for other projects as well. I asked Toño to do the lead on the track Disintegration, which he did a phenomenal job on. We rendered a couple of things back and forth through email, changed a couple of parts here and there, but the final take is phenomenal. I really like what he did there. It sounds very smooth, very coherent, and it's also another guy to have on the album, which I'm really happy about. Not only a great sound engineer and a producer, Braeden is also an incredible saxophone player. And for some reason, I got it in my head that I wanted to add to the already existing chaos on the track Vacuous. I wanted to add a saxophone. And so amidst all of the instrumentation and layers of vocals, there's a saxophone there, mostly heard at the very, very end where Braeden takes that melody and kind of... I've always imagined that being somebody walking on a misty, rainy cobble street in Paris at night with, you know, incandescent lighting and such. So I've always kind of pictured that when taking the song to an end or whatnot, but everybody's interpretation would be different. So yeah, Braeden did an incredible job on the album. It's really nice to have an instrument that I've never worked with before and incorporate that into the track, and I'm really happy on how it turned out. One of the only times, one of four or five times that Trailight ever played live was back in 2014, I think. We shared a bill with a band called Alchemy Chamber. One of the musicians there was Anna. She's a cellist in that band. And when I wrote the track Soliloquy, I really heard a cello piece, although there wasn't anything that I had in mind specifically as far as writing something. So I contacted Anna and I asked her if she would be willing and interested to contribute a part to it, and she said yes, and I was really, really excited. So I sent her the track, she sent me her idea, and I said, phenomenal, do that. And basically the first idea that she came up with ended up on that track, and I think it sounds really, really cool. It's really great to have an actual cello performance on it up until then, and I still do. I use a lot of instrumental MIDI, symphonic MIDI for those parts, and it was really nice to have an actual cellist play on that part. Meris already appeared on a couple of my projects. The first one, her debut appearance, was on Endure the Fire, where she narrated the entire album. And the last album, Sophia, where she did backing vocals to the track Dance. On this album, she did backing vocals to the title track, Chasing Daylight, and Vacuous as well. Meris has got a phenomenal voice. It's always a ton of fun working with her in the studio, and I'm sure she's gonna come back and do vocals on future projects as well. It's now become a staple to have Meris on my project. Her voice sounds very similar to mine. It's nice to have a voice sound that sounds like mine, that's feminine and sounds so great as hers. So I'm sure we'll be hearing a lot more of Meris on my future projects. Alannah came highly recommended by a mutual friend of ours, Jacob. I asked Jacob one day if he knew of any local female vocalists, that would be interested in doing any backing vocals for my project, and without any hesitation or momentary pause, Jacob mentioned Alannah Clark, and so he got us in touch, and I sent her the tracks, and I told her what I was looking for, and she agreed, despite the fact that my music is quite a departure from hers. Alannah came over one afternoon to track vocals for Chasing Daylight and Vacuous as well, and she did a remarkable performance. It's always great to have somebody that knows their stuff so well that you can just let them do their thing. Not only a great vocalist, Alannah is a multi-instrumentalist and very accomplished musician, and I'm sure that we'll also be hearing a lot more from Alannah and on my future projects as well. One of the most colossal voices in heavy music that I know of, and unfortunately a lot of people don't know, but hopefully that's going to change, Conan Freeman, who is now the bass player of the band iMonolith and who contributed a little bit of backing vocals on The Primitive Mountain, is now back contributing vocals to the track Vacuous. And by now you've heard me mention the track Vacuous quite a few times, and you can probably imagine how many vocal tracks there are on that track alone. Conan's distinct voice drives a certain part of that song in such a beautiful way, in such a visceral way, that I was so happy to hear the end result. He tracked it in his house and Dave went to mix it. I didn't really hear what he was doing until Dave sent me the mixes back, and I heard that voice and I was like, wow, this is amazing. So it's so nice to have him back to do backing vocals, and I'm so happy that he's now part of iMonolith and hopefully getting on the world stage, because more people need to know about Conan, indeed. I met Dave while we were working together on The Primitive Mountain. As some of you may know, Dave laid down all the vocals for The Primitive Mountain, and most of you know Dave from his decade-long career with Canadian thrash metal band Annihilator. Since then, Dave has been really concentrating on his mixing engineering skills, which have seemed to have grown exponentially. Dave mixed the last album, Sophia, and he has mixed this album, Chasing Daylight, as well. Dave also appears on a re-recording of a cover song that we did back in 2015 of a Nick Cave and the Bad Seeds song called The Weeping Song, in which he did a duet with Burton C. Bell, then of Fear Factory, now of Ascension of the Watchers. It's always great to have Dave involved in any of the projects that I've done because he's got such a great musical vision, and all of what I know about recording vocals and tracking vocals and performing vocals comes from Dave. I've learned so much from him throughout the years, and at this juncture I think it's important to mention that Dave, Cory, and Conan used to be involved musically together quite a lot, and it's so inspiring for me to be involved with those three people because they have such high standards of musical vision and such high standards of musical ability that for me, not having nearly as much standards as they do, or ability more so as they do, the standards I have, the ability is questionable, I suppose. But having them involved in what it is that I do and kind of bouncing off ideas with them, and it's really inspiring for me to be involved at that capacity with such high caliber musicians. It kind of pushes me to become a better musician, to open up my ears, to open up my vision to something a lot greater. And so Dave is no exception, obviously. He is an incredibly talented musician, an incredible singer, and it's great that he is now crafting his art as a mixing engineer, and I'm sure we'll be working together lots in the future as well.